Exciting updates to my ESP NeoPixel web server. It's not a web server anymore. I installed a MQTT service broker on one of my Raspberry Pis, connected to the network, and changed the code on the ESP8266 to exchange MQTT messages with the service broker. Let's first have a look at the code. Okay, some of it changed, some of it was the same. We include a library that's called pubsubclient. You can find it when you search it in the library manager. Search for pubsub. And you have the pubsubclient by Nick O'Leary. So we create two subscriptions. And the nice thing about this, you don't have to register it on the broker. You just have to name it. I called ESP1 out for all outgoing messages and ESP1 in for all incoming messages. Here comes the SSID and the password of my router. Okay, not really my credentials, but I think you know what goes in there. And the IP address of the MQTT server. It's the IP address the DNS server of the router gave to the Raspberry Pi MQTT broker. We create an instance of the pubsub client, and most of it stays the same. We configured the NeoPixels. We configured the Wi-Fi. This time we made an extra function for it. And try to connect to the MQTT server. And we set a function that is called when the ESP received a message from the server. And here it is. The debug messages. Since we only want to set a color for all the NeoPixels, we check the payload and create a string out of the payload. And we use our known function setNeoColor to lighten up the NeoPixels. In the loop function, we check if our pubsub client is still connected. If not, we call a function that we created to reconnect. Since we're not only receiving messages, but also sending messages, we check, wait 10 minutes, or if the message changed, to publish the message to the server back. All quite simple. Only looks a bit complicated because of many, many debug output. Let's see this in action. Using the Android app MQTT dashboard and recreate a new connection. Client ID, so let's say home. The server is the IP address of the MQTT broker. Port is a default port. The default port is 1883. And we didn't set a username and password on the broker. So we can try to connect. Yeah, we are connected to the service broker. Now we use publish. Add a color picker and ESP NeoPixel topic. A topic is a subscription name. We set it to ESP-1. -in. And we send the hexadecimal value in the color picker. We subscribe to the topic because we set the ESP to resend the selected color to the broker. NSP NeoPixel color. The topic was ESP dash one dash out. So let's try to select a color. Let's pick blue, and it's blue. In our script description, the color that is selected. Let's select another color, red. And our subscription changed. Let's try it again. Green. We don't have green. Ooh, nice. And a darker blue. And of course, to turn it off, we select black. Booyah! If you want to create your own smart home, the MQTT protocol is a nice feature. It's easy to configure. The broker software even runs on a Raspberry Pi. And even those tiny little ESP can handle these protocols. If you only want one ESP and one NeoPixel, it's probably better and easier if you use a web server code. But if you don't think it should be the end, if you want to attach sensors and many more ESPs around your home, and you don't think it should stop there, I think MQTT is a good start to automate your home, to make your home smarter. I'll leave a link to the code, the modified code, in the description. If you liked the video, comment, like, subscribe, and share it. Bye.